in the love tonight. We're gonna have a little intention the sound immersion work that I like to do is more of a journey than just the sound bath. Of course, it's gonna definitely have a sound bath included, but I feel like it's beneficial to have some intention with it. You know? So this month, working with the vibration of love, which we all are familiar with, right? And I wanted to just kind of share on it a little bit and kind of touch on what, you know, love is one of those things that you can't measure with a stick. You know, it's an intangible thing, right? And yet we all experience it. It comes in many ways, and shows up in many ways, from loving our dog to our children to our parents, our families, lovers, and loved ones, and friends. And it shows up in so many different ways, doesn't it? You know, love of life itself. How about love of ourselves? Practice of loving ourselves. And so, just taking that a little bit deeper on this journey, the sacred journey of contemplation, I guess, of unconditional love. Years ago, I did a share when I was in Raleigh, North Carolina, in the Center for Spiritual Living, and I did a Sunday inspirational share on unconditional love. And, oh, I put my heart and soul into that talk, and I was so like, kind of got it, you know, like unconditional love is that love we have that's underneath conditions, unconditional, no conditions, right? And I did this wonderful share, and I just felt so like inspired myself. And after I shared, this guy came up to me and said, "There's no such thing as unconditional love. Everybody has conditions on their love. Look at this." And he's giving me all these examples of why, you know. You say something, and someone doesn't do what you want them to do. Take your love away. They take their love away from you. And he was really adamant about it. I'm like, oh my God. He's right. He's a good argument. So, I had to think about it, thought about it, you know. And I think he might be right. What I learned, I think, is that he's probably not right. That unconditional love is something that we can experience. And I think that it's the practice. I don't think it's a given. I think it's something we cultivate. You know? And unconditional love doesn't mean we stay in relationships that are bad or we have healthy boundaries in our relationships. That's not what unconditional love is. You know? It's the capacity and ability to see underneath. And ultimately, it really comes down to the unconditional love for our own self. If we can't do that, how can we really truly practice unconditional love for others? Which, of course, this is easier said than done, right? So again, it's a practice, right? To love ourselves, right? When we